Hi, I'm Terry B from Tip of the Iceberg, and I thought I would try my hand at vlogging. This is the first time I've made a video blog, so this should be fun. Thank you for joining me. I've decided to use as my backdrop my TBR, To Be Read, pile. This is not just my collection of To Be Read books. Some of these are my husband's, so I can't take credit for all of the beautiful architecture behind me. Probably not a smart thing to do here in Southern California, where we do have earthquakes roll through every once in a while. So far, none of them have fallen over, so I've been very lucky about that. I have grouped together some of these books, and one of the groupings is for the Japanese Literature Challenge, hosted by Dolce Polizza every summer. Starts at the end of this month, so if you think you would like to read some Japanese literature, please join Dolce Polizza and the rest of us as we read through some Japanese literature. And for that challenge, I've set aside Rashomon and 17 Other Stories by Runosuke Akutagawa. And I picked this one up because it has an introduction by Haruki Murakami. And any of you who have hung out here at Tip of the Iceberg for any length of time knows that I like Haruki Murakami quite a bit, and I've read and reviewed some of his other, some of his books last year for the Japanese Literature Challenge. Master Puppeteer by Katherine Peterson. She has won several Newbery Awards, including one for Bridge to Terabithia. And I just loved this cover. I found it on the YA shelf, and it sounded like a very good story, and again, the cover caught my eye. Coin Locker Babies by Ru Murakami. I found this on the shelf next to Haruki Murakami, so of course I had to find out who is Ru Murakami. I still don't know, but hopefully I'll find out soon. Black Rain by Masuji Ebuse. And this novel is centered around the story of a young woman caught in the radioactive black rain that fell after the bombing of Hiroshima. And I have an interest in the history of Japan and the different things that happened surrounding World War II, so this should be an interesting read for me. It probably will not be necessarily a happy read, but I think I'll find it interesting. Japanese Gothic Tales by Azumi Kiyoka. I think I picked this title up from Tanabata from In Spring It Is the Dawn. And she reads an awful lot of Japanese literature and keeps a wonderful list. So if you're interested, you might want to go look at that. And it just sounded Japanese, Gothic. I like both. Snow Country by Yasunari Kawabata. I loved the cover. I thought that was beautiful. And the description says that it tells the story of wasted love set amid the desolate beauty of Western Japan, the snowiest region on earth. So it sounded beautiful. It sounded like maybe a heart-wrenching story. And the synopsis caught my eye. Tales of Moonlight and Rain by Ueda Akinari. Again, another suggestion by Tanabata. And lastly, for the Japanese Literature Challenge, I have set aside I Am a Cat by Soseki Natsume. Soseki Natsume lived from 1867 to 1916, and I just loved this description. I Am the Cat is the chronicle of an unloved, unwanted, wandering kitten who spends all his time observing human nature. And it just sounded rather charming. It's probably quite humorous. And if you've ever wanted to know what kittens think about humans, that maybe is a book for you. Carl V from Stainless Steel Droppings hosts the RIP Challenge every fall. I hope he does it again this year because I've set aside a few titles. One of them is We Have Always Lived in the Castle by Shirley Jackson. Creepy cover. The back, too. I read Shirley Jackson's The Lottery many years ago, and I remember liking her writing style. I remember being intrigued by the story, so several people had read this last year, and I thought I would pick that up and put it on my stack of books to read for that challenge. I've got two ghost stories set aside for the RIP challenge. They're both written by John Harwood, and I don't know anything about John Harwood, but they're ghost stories. I don't remember who recommended them, but somebody on out there in blogland did recommend. This one has a timid librarian, a ghostwriter. And as a librarian, I'm interested in books that depict librarians. Timid is not usually the way I would describe the librarians that I know. We're not all timid. The seance. The back of this says, spirits, possession, and murder entwined in this haunting Victorian-era gothic tale for fans of Wilkie Collins. So, gothic sounds good to me.